So let's talk about the conservation factors associated with hook configuration, namely one hook versus two hooks. But let's just start with a little bit of a background on Hogy's firsthand experience with it. Last season, we worked with the Massachusetts Department of Marine Fisheries on their citizen science project for striped bass, which really involves anglers like you and me, documenting their experiences with using, well, this study is bait and lures for striped bass. And in the study, it asks anglers to report, there's really 10 different factors. One, they want you to document the lure type, where in the water column you hook the fish, the number of hooks you have on your lure, the hook type, single or treble, where the fish was hooked, i.e. where in the mouth it was hooked, how long you fought it for, the amount of time it spent out of the water, how long it took you to release it, how much blood associated with the hook. Some spots have more blood than others. And then what they call the vitality of the release, how strongly the striped bass swims away. Now, we helped film the instructions, the video instructions via Salty Cape, and supported and endorsed it with Hogy Lure Company. ASGA, American Saltwater Guides Association, got involved helping to promote the project, brought in GotOne, which is the super convenient app that we all use to log these catches into the system. And over the course of almost two seasons now, I've been logging, we've logged, 50 striped bass so far. And so this year alone, and then a bunch last year. So we have very, close insight to the hook placement. Now, we haven't looked at all the data until recently, but one thing that's for sure is this study caused me, as the owner of a fishing tackle company that makes lures, thousands of lures going to thousands of anglers, really think about the rigging and how we have the hooks on our lures. Now, obviously, intuitively, we all know that two hooks is safer than one hook, but I sort of assumed it was lost in the rounding. When I say assumed, it's probably from lack of thinking about it or paying attention. But I'll tell you one thing, I'm paying close attention to it now. Striped bass, we all know, needs our attention, just like many other game fish like snook and tarpon and cobia. Like any species in nature, it's common sense and conservation associated with it.